do you need for your projects? Cardstock. Y'all know my answer is always cardstock. This is actually what I got. I got it at Staples. It was on clearance. I've been using it for a while. It's 250 sheets, you can see. I maybe have used half of it. Yeah, I've probably used half of it. It lasts a long time. That's what I recommend for all your projects. That's what you I suggest you use. All right? So, again, I don't want you to spend a lot of money on this. I mainly want you to have fun. Okay? So, grab your cardstock and some paints, and let's get started. Okay, so, let me back that up just a hair. There we go. All right, I told you to grab your cardstock and your paints. And I decided to also, if you have it, grab some music or an old book page or book pages. When I get quiet, it's because I'm drinking my coffee. Because, yeah, I'm still working on my coffee this morning. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to glue this down to here. Since I'm going to paint it up afterwards, I am just going to use my glue stick because the acrylic paint will also help hold it. If you don't have any old book pages or sheet music, you know, I'm having trouble talking, y'all. My coffee hadn't kicked in yet. If you don't have anything like this to put down, get some. Hit the flea market, used bookstore, something. I don't ever pay much for this, but I love them. Okay, but B, just stamp some black stamps into your background, maybe. All right, so I'm just going to put this down on here, just like this. Okay. And here, I'll use this just to scrape it to make sure it is down good. All right, this corner is the only one that really isn't, so let's get some glue down here. And again, I probably don't need to do that because when I start painting it, what are we doing? I didn't tell you. Okay, project number one is one of my absolute favorite things, circles. All right. I got this from my friend Emily a long time ago. So, and it's still one of my favorite things to do. So I've got my paper. I've got me some sheet music on there for some interest, and I've got me some colors. What colors do I have? Christmas red, tropic orange, cameo pink, bright yellow, wild green, calypso blue, navy blue, and purple passion. All right, so some of these are deco art, some of these are Americana, some of them are Apple Barrel. They're all craft paints. All right, so what do you do? Well, pick a color, any color, and a finger. Yep, we are finger painting. All right, you can either do the center or you can do the outside circles. Okay, and what I generally do is both. I will make some outsides and some insides and just use up that little dollop of paint that I put down before I move to the next color. I didn't say this, but surely y'all all know that pretty much if I'm telling you we're doing anything, the very first thing you need is baby wipes. All right, so when you get all the red on there you want, Clean off your fingers. Clean off your craft mat. Give it a quick dry, because you do want this to be dry. Because you don't want your colors to blend, you want them to layer. All right, and it's really thin paint, not much, so it won't take a lot. Pick another color, doesn't matter which one, and do it again. And you can do centers in the ones you've already done. You can do centers all by themselves. You can do around the centers you've made. Whatever you want to do. And you can also make just some brand new ones. And again, just do this till that little dollop of purple you've already brought out is all used up. I'm going to stop the video, start it again so we can do it on fast forward and do the rest of these colors. I hope you're playing along because this is super easy, super fun, okay? So I have got my dots and splotches and circles, and I'm gonna let this dry before I do anything else. But I wanted to say a couple of things that I didn't say before. One is, my center is a dot and my first circle is a dot. But after that, they are pieces of a circle, okay? And I just mix up the colors. Then the last thing I did, and I think the camera shut off in the middle of it, was I was going through and redoing some of my centers. And some of my, center was too big or I didn't like the color. I put another color in the center of that center. So anyway, I'm going to let this dry because some of those globs of paint are pretty thick. And I want it good and dry before I go to the next stage. All right. So get your circles painted. Get them completely dry. Go grab you some lunch or something because it's lunchtime. And we'll be back. It is good and dry now. And I just want to kind of fill in everywhere that the paint circles aren't. So I picked a color that isn't in there yet. This is Lavender Sachet. And I'm just going to get a baby wipe because I want to thin this. And that's the easiest way to do it. I'm going to take my baby wipe and my paint, and I'm just gonna pick up a little paint and mush it in. It's going over all these colors, so some of them are getting pushed in the background a little bit, but not a lot. Kind of muting everything. Also making it a little fun. And I'm just going to take a clean spot now. And that. And then I'm going to take the one I was using earlier and clean up all that purple. And blue and green and everything else that's still on this craft mat. Okay. And I'm going to let it dry again. But this time I'm going to do it with my heat gun. It is all dry. And I want to add a border. So I have got my Diane Reeveley stamp mount that has the wavy side. I love this thing. And my black marker. And it is the quickest, easiest way to make a cool border. And I do this all the time because it is quick, easy, fun, and I like it. Okay, so just gonna do this. And voila. Border. Go to the other end, do the same thing. And voila, border. And I don't want this one is quite as thick. And when you have a side that's longer than your thing, you just match it up again. Just match it up, move it down, and continue. There you go. Just that easy. All right, I'm going to do the last side. And then I'm going to give this a quick dry. Okay, and there is that. Clean off this edge. Cap this. And once again, give it a quick dry. To finish off this page, I want to find an image and a quote. But we're trying to do all this in one day, so rather than make something new, I'm going to raid my stash. So let's see what I have got that I want to use. It can be something pre-bought, something I've made and have left over from something else. It can be pretty much anything at this point. Don't really have a plan. I literally am just seeing what I have. Oops, I have that. Alright, I like Once Upon a Time. And I like the Today and Smile, but now that's just really talking to me, so let's see what else I've got. Too small. And flowers. Oh, here's just a hodgepodge of stuff. So let's see what's in here in this just hodgepodge of stuff. Nope, nothing I'm just loving. Flowers. Here's some words, let's see. Oh, here we go. How about we use celebrate? Because it's my birthday. So I like the celebrate best day. All right, we're gonna use this. All right, celebrate best day ever. And you know this funny thing is that was the top part too. Oh, and a birth and a cupcake. Okay, I'm liking that. All right, so let's use these. And these are stickers, so those are really quick. All right. Now let's make sure when I go to put one here, I still like them. And I do. So let's start with my cupcake. And let's put the cupcake right there. Ha ha ha. And celebrate. Actually, I start with the hooray because I think I want to make the hooray go like from one corner to another. So let's do that first. So like it's hanging from the, oops, like it's hanging from the borders. Like that. Okay. And same thing with this other one. And I'm going to go from that one to that one. And this little tassel came off. So let's see if we can reattach him. There. And celebrate. And then the best day ever. Right there. Okay. So now I'm just going to take a black pen. Which one? Going to take a black pen and I'm just going to kind of go around some of this stuff just to kind of anchor it into my background. All right. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to put it on fast forward so you don't have to watch every little line I make. Okay, so I outlined all my stuff in black, and then I also just took my white pen, traced inside, and then also wrote around the edges. Real sloppy because I wanted it quick and fun and fast. And it just says happy birthday to me over and over again because it's my birthday! All right, so that is project number one. You don't have to make it say happy birthday to me because it's not your birthday. Or hey, maybe it is. You can make it anything you want. Just basically make your circle background and then decorate it up however you want to be your first page. Okay, guys, that's project number one done. Now to project number two.